Okay, another tight fit. The new Hyperloop, the capsule-like travel system just unveiled by Tesla's founder Elon Musk. He claims the system would carry people from LA to San Francisco in a half hour. So what would it be like traveling inside the thing, going that fast? Musk explained during yesterday's conference call.
It would actually feel a lot like being in an airplane. So there'd be an initial acceleration, and once you're traveling at speed, you wouldn't really notice the speed at all. So it would just feel extremely smooth, like you're riding on a cushion of air, really. You wouldn't feel lateral acceleration, you know, from side-to-side acceleration, because the pod would bang against the side of the tube. So the G-forces would always point down. It's just extremely difficult, I suppose, to crash. You know, unlike an airplane, it's not really moving in three dimensions. It's not like it's going to fall out of the sky, essentially, nor can it be really derailed as a train can. The thought I had was to actually, in the pylons on which the tube is mounted, to have earthquake dampers. It's sort of similar to the sort of thing that you have in buildings in California. So that they're like basically shock absorbers. So you have two laterally mounted for XY to take out XY movement, and then one vertically mounted in the post to take out vertical movement. Now there's going to be potentially some earthquake that's so gigantic that it overcomes the dampers, but then, you know, we have that same problem in buildings. You know? Mm-hmm. So, I mean, if LA falls down, well, I guess the Hyperloop will too. But it should be, in relative to say a train, where you can't really do that with tracks. It should be quite a bit safer. I'm not trying to, you know, go make a ton of money on this, but I would like to see it come to fruition, and I think it might help if I did a demonstration article. So I think I probably will do that, actually.